All right, today we're going to talk about Sorrowland by River Solomon. I received an eARC from NetGalley. All opinions are my own. I'm a little late on this one. This came out May 4th, but I was overwhelmed by all the books, and I couldn't read it till now, but I am so glad I did. Like I do in all my reviews at the top, I'll just briefly talk about my emotional experience, my star reading, where I was when I picked it up, so you can, like, I don't know, kind of put it into the biased context that is me bringing my own baggage to a reading experience. And then we'll get into a brief synopsis and my opinions on different elements of the story with spoiler free. Like, I'm not talking any spoiler content in this video. So, emotional experience. Well, I picked this up after I've been on like a reading high. I have been loving so many of the things I read the month that I read this book, and I had just finished Wild Seed by Octavia Butler. And Wild Seed really got me in the mood for the themes that I was sure were going to be in Sorrowland. And I was also pretty sure about the tone I was going to get. And I was right. I read it in 3 days, which is really fast for me for this length of book. I think it's about 360 pages. They don't give you page numbers in eARC, so it's hard for me to tell. But it was a great experience. It's my favorite of River Solomon's works, but it definitely feels like a work by Fair. So yeah, that is my emotional experience. 4 to 4.5 out of 5 stars. I'm so glad I read it. It surpassed my expectations. I did not know what I would get, and I was very happy with the product that I got. So now we're going to do a brief synopsis. We have Vern. When we meet her, she's 15 years old. She is in a forest. She is giving birth to her children. That is where we start. That is the beginning. So at its core, without telling you anything else of the story, this is about motherhood. This is about Vern and her children and raising them in this forest. And Vern also is trying to figure out what is happening to her, because some less than normal things are occurring in her life. And I'll keep it very vague like that, just because I feel like discovery is so fun for this. And it's also about Vern, though, at the same time, as she's just trying to figure out the, like, what is going on. She's also trying to figure out, like, where she fits. Like, it's more like a human question, right? Like, where do I fit into things, and who am I to myself? Because Vern has always felt like someone who kind of pushes against the grain. A lot of that might be her upbringing. Some of it could be her herself. It's complex, because being a human is a complex thing. None of us are very simple, right? And that's the story. And in terms of like pacing, I would say it's medium paced. We have a lot of introspective quiet moments, but we have a lot of like tense page turning reveal moments is what I would say. And I loved both of them equally. I really don't think I would have liked this story as much without the quiet moments, but at the same time, it's the mystery and the thrilling moments that I'm like, this is what made it such an enjoyable like story to consume. So I would say that that's kind of the general pacing you're into for this. And let's talk about some stuff I really liked. In general, I love a story with survival elements, and that's definitely part of it with Vern and her children in a forest. I don't know why I could read just people living in a forest. I mean, I've actually done that. I read a book called The Innocents. These were people just living in northern Canada, and it was just them trying to get by. I like survival stories. A good part of this book is about survival, but in different ways. But to some extent, it also just had like good old-fashioned hunter-gatherer survival elements, which apparently is a thing I really love. I also really love creepy mystery elements. And yeah, that's definitely here. It's creepy. It's mysterious. You're like, what? Some of the imagery, if you are a visual person, is going to be grotesque. I can tell. I don't see things when I read, but there were moments where I'm like, that's an unpleasant image. I'm glad I didn't get to see that. So keep that in mind, that the creep factor, it's high. Like, this is a book that I started reading at night and I almost had regrets. But I'm also like a baby, so keep that in mind. But I enjoyed that. Like, that was a part of the intrigue for the story for me. Things that I also didn't expect, but I am always here for, there is found family in this book. It's wonderful. It's one of my favorite moments of found family. I was highlighting things and I was voxing my friend Judith, who had also read this book. And I'm like, oh my God, this exact thing just happened, because it just like my heart. It was so great. And also, we shouldn't be surprised if you know me and my reading tastes, the character relationship development was great, was human, was organic, was genuine. I was there. I cared about it. I mean, it was much stronger than I expected, and I loved all of it. I thought everything made sense and was so human and grounded. So those are things that I love in stories that were in this story. So now we need to talk about the writing, which is, I think, another huge reason why I really enjoyed this work. So first of all, River Solomon's authorial voice can be so sarcastically biting at times. Like, there is obviously a thematic agenda to this piece, and I liked how that was accomplished with the writing, particularly with the sarcastic tone. A scene will be set up, like, any, it could be like a quote from something in our real life, and then they'll just sarcastically go, because of course we would do that over doing this. And I enjoy that. I enjoy that slight fourth wall breaking once in a while. That is a preference of mine. Although it is quite introspective. Like, you are really close to the point of views you're with. You're primarily with Vern, although you're not always with Vern, and she thinks a lot. Like, she spends a lot of her time thinking, and it makes sense. There's just a lot of things that Vern's trying to unpack in the middle of trying to also unpack this mystery and surviving. Like, where does she have the time? I don't even know, but I really like the voice and just that perspective. Like, there is a, I don't really know how to describe it, but there's a perspective to a River Solomon work that feels like them. Like, I've read An Unkindness of Ghosts, which is a much slower paced space opera mystery that also has a very thematic agenda. And I was reading this one, which is much faster paced, and it still felt like they were with me, that the author, like, they were next to me. It's kind of similar to what I get when I read a Jemison work or an Octavia Butler. Like, they are authors whose voices I know. And that's still very prevalent here. So if you've read An Unkindness of Ghosts and you liked that, you're probably really going to like it here. Like, the writing was just so good to me. And that's honestly not something that I always notice unless it's something I really love. Now, if you're someone who watches this channel and you're like, I normally don't like the authors Angela likes, then maybe this is good for you to know. Although I would still give it a chance because I just think this story was a really good blend of thematic content and engaging story. I think some books try to do both and don't do it well, and I personally thought for my taste it did it great here. Another thing we need to talk about with the writing though is that it is raw. It is sometimes very bleak. It's very emotional in how it explores certain things, and some things, like I said, that were grotesque, there are other things that are also written in very graphic, raw ways. That is something you will find in this writing style, and sometimes it's done in a way that's not meant to shield you from the moment. And maybe that's not something you like in your writing, but like, it was something I really appreciated. I don't read it a lot, and when I have read it, it never felt genuine to me. And this didn't feel like edgelord for the point of being edgelord, or like, it didn't feel fake. It felt very like, oh yes, this is a moment where we needed to have just that statement said completely raw. It really worked for me. And so I mentioned that there were a bunch of themes, and there are so many themes. I was going through all of the things I'd annotated, and I have like a half sheet of different themes that we'll get. And I don't wanna, like, I don't try to look at my notes a lot, but I don't wanna forget anything. But we've got motherhood, in general, parenthood, nature versus nurture. We have the relationship between humans and nature. We have the idea of, is, like, you know, authority actually good? Like, there's definitely a lot of discussion of, like, what are the pros to civilization? There's definitely a lot of that in here. And what is freedom? Especially, what is freedom in the United States? Like, what does that actually mean? There is definitely exploration of trauma and pride in a person and how that goes. The idea of light versus dark, and in a way that I haven't really explored it before. Not light versus dark and comparing it to good versus bad, but just talking about the pros and cons of something that is in the light and something that is in the dark. And it kind of comes from Vern's relationship to the dark and the forest and everything like that. I really liked that part. I thought that was really cool. There's also for sure a lot of just, what is it like to be Black in America? Because that is something you can't escape in this story. We also have a huge theme of belonging. What does it mean to belong to a place, especially like if you're Black in America? What does it mean to belong to a country that for the most part does not make room for you unless you are pushing and shoving to make way, right? And there's also like one of the main characters is a Native American. So we have, what is it like to belong in a place that really didn't want you to be there, tried really hard to kick you out? And they even have a relationship to their tribe, but then was taken away from their tribe and now feel in this, like, no man's land of how they are a part of their tribe, but wouldn't feel at home or comfortable in their tribe because they've lost this connection to language. There is so much in this story, and I really appreciated it, and I really loved all the sentences. There was one sentence that really sticks with me. It's, what people need to live is people. And I don't know why I really like that quote. I think it does resonate with me as someone who, like, definitely values my human relationships more than I value what I own, more than I value where I live. Like, all of those things can change and will change over and over again, but it's the people in my life that really make things worth living and who support me when living is hard. There's also lines that I thought were funny, like, the U.S. was a catalog of known wrongs, which, it's not wrong, and it's just, there are so many quotable moments. So like I said, it's a story with an action-packed, mystery, creepy plot, but also really rich, thematic, introspective content, and I don't see many works that do both of them really well. I really like Vern. I thought Vern was a really relatable character. If I were to guess, I would say that maybe Rivers Solomon put a lot of themselves into the creation of Vern. I'm not sure. But, like, this is a character that feels so human to me and so complex. And I really, really loved reading this story. It was a highlight of my week. I love a book that I can't put down. Like, what can I say? And if you've made it this far and you just want to leave me an emoji, leave me, I guess trees for the forest, because that's where we start and that's, like, the only thing I've told you in this story. So leave me a forest emoji. Let me know if you think you're going to pick this up or if you have any other questions and you want, like, something very specifically answered. And if you've read it, make sure to type spoilers and type enter a few times. And otherwise, like if you liked it, subscribe if you want to, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.